Okay, so as you can see on my laptop screen here, I'm currently using my phone camera as my video source on vMix, and I can actually stream this, record it, do whatever thing I want to do with this. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use your phone camera on vMix. Probably your church live service is going on, you don't have a proper camera setup to record and stream your service live across all social media platforms. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use your phone camera and bring it in on vMix and also stream, record your live service or anything you want to do with it. So if you are new to this channel, please subscribe. If you're a returning subscriber, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up so more people can see this particular content. Okay, my phone camera quality, it's low, that's why it's like that, and the resolution I set on the phone is 1080, which is why it's a bit, seems like it's dragging. You can see there on my screen. So I'm going to show you how to do this. So the better the quality of your phone, or the better the camera quality of your phone, the better resolution you are going to get for your recording. Okay, now I would love you to get a pen and paper with you, just keep it by the side, because you're going to jot some things down that you are going to need in the course of this video. Okay, let's get the IP address of the network connected to your PC. Okay, so what you have to do is click on the Wi-Fi sign here. As you can see on my PC here, see the Wi-Fi, my laptop is currently connected to my phone hotspot. You can see it here. So click on properties. Now when you click on properties, this will pop up as you can see on my laptop. Now scroll down a little bit, you will see the IPv4 address. Now this is what we need. Okay, the IPv4 address, let me just highlight that so that you see the IPv4 address is what we need. As you can see it there on my screen, so this is what we need. You can just write it down somewhere because you're going to need it in the course of this video. Now let's set up our SRT on vMix. Okay, now go over to your vMix. My eye is already open here. Click on add input here. You can see the add input by the left. Click on add input and select stream SRT. You can see stream SRT. Now the stream type, you can see it's on RTSP, sorry, over UDP. Now click on it and select SRT listener, not the SRT caller or SRT rendezvous. Select the SRT listener. Okay, so select that and take note of the port number. You can just change it to anything. Let me just leave my as maybe 2021. So you can put any number there you want, but it can just put any number at all that you want to be there. You can still leave the 5000 there, no problem. Just take note of the number you are putting on the port. Okay, so take note of the number that you are going to put in this particular place, or you can just make do with the default 5000 that is already there. Okay, so click on OK. As you can see, our SRT is currently blank, nothing is showing. You can see here, it's currently blank, nothing is showing. Now the next thing we are going to do is just watch my phone screen there. Go over to your phone and search on Play Store. Okay, go over to your phone, search for Play Store. As you can see on my phone screen here, search for Play Store. Open the Play Store app. Now we are going to install an app which will enable us to connect our phone to our vMix. Now let's search for camera FI Live. You can see camera FI Live, so let's search for that. You can see the first one is what the one we are going to be using, the one with the live icon on the picture. You can see it's the camera FI Live. So we're going to install the app on my phone. Okay, so I'm just going to wait for the app to install. It's going to take a bit of time, that's pending on the network. So our camera FI Live app is already finished installing on my phone, as you can see there. So let's open it and set up our SRT. Okay, the app is currently opening. Oh, still opening, still opening. This thing is actually very easy to do. You can even stream it live and get the best quality. Okay, so we are not going for the 1 month free, no thanks. You can still use the driver, the free version, to do whatever thing you want to do. If you want to mix this, yes, close, continue, don't worry. You can still use the free version to do whatever thing you want to do with it, play around with it, and it won't affect your live broadcast. Okay, now when the app has already finished opening, you will see a whole bunch of other and tabs here. You can see YouTube, Facebook, Twitch, Restream, okay, Wowza, SRT, custom RTMP, vMix, OBS. I'm also going to be covering a video on OBS, but in this particular one, we are going to be looking at only on vMix. Okay, now you can see the vMix tab there. Click on the vMix tab, then when it's opened, you're going to see the SRTs. You can see the //. Now, the first thing we are going to do after this is to put in our Wi-Fi IP address that is connected to our laptop. Okay, so I already show you how to get that, but in case you missed that as well, this is the code we need, which is the IPv4 address. So I'm just going to type that into my phone, as you can see on the screen. Okay, 192.168.43.50. Now we are going to give a little, just the two dots. You can see here. Now the default vMix RTMP server, which is 5000. You can see the example, they already typed it for me there, but because I'm not using it, I already changed the number to 2021. I'm not going to type 5000 here after this. So what we're going to type is the port number I put in, which is 2021. Okay, onto 2021, sorry, 21, and after that you are done. There's nothing else to do. Click on OK, and that is it. Now click on start. Now before starting, make sure your phone is on portrait mode like this. Okay, so before starting, make sure your phone is on portrait mode like this. Okay, so just click on the start button. See, now to require you to give the app permission to your camera, microphone, blah blah blah, just allow, give it all the permission to your camera, to your file, everything. Okay, so allow permission. So I've already done that. Allow display over other apps. Okay, now it's ready to go. Now click on the start button. Alright, so this is it. Now before starting your video, as you can see, it's currently on portrait. All you have to do is put it on landscape. Make sure your phone is like this. Let me just put this close. Make sure your phone is on landscape before you click the go button, as you can see there. Make sure your phone is on landscape like this. Now if your phone is on landscape, once you click on go button, your broadcast, your video will start with landscape. Now when it's on portrait, when you click on the go option, it will start with portrait like this. So make sure it's on landscape like this. Just keep it like this. Your phone ready to film whatever thing you want to do like this before you click on the go button. Okay, so let me just click that go here. Start in landscape mode. Now it's going to start in landscape mode. So as you can see, it's currently on landscape. You can see here, it's currently on landscape. This is it. You can see it's displaying. Now I want to change it to the front camera. You can see all you have to do is click on the camera sign and select the other button there. You can see it on my phone. Okay, I'm also displaying my phone on the screen so you can see it on my phone. Click on it, select the single. Okay, it will change to portrait. So it's as if the thing is dragging a little bit. That is because of my phone. So when you want to do something like this, it requires you to use a very strong phone and a very strong network. Okay, so that you won't experience what I'm currently experiencing. You can see this kind of dragging a little bit. So both the audio and the video, you can make use of it all as well. Okay, you can see. So both the audio and the video, you can make use of everything as well. So you can see the audio sign here. You can link your video and audio. It's already linked automatically. I can turn it off and I can turn it on. Now the audio monitoring, you can check audio or noise of the audio in advance. You can see here. You can use the audio volume frame key. And you can also set your camera to, maybe you want it on pro to brighten it or whatever thing you want to do. There's a whole bunch of things. See here. See, can zoom in a little bit, then zoom out, so it will take a bit of time to reflect there. You can see here, and then you can zoom out too as well. And I can turn the pro option off, can do a whole lot of different things. You can even take picture, you can use pen to write on the screen. You can see, no, let me put it on red. You can see here. You can see, don't mind what I just, my handwriting, I see. I use it to write on the screen, so I've just deleted that. So you can do a whole bunch of turn that option. You can turn your flash on. You can see the flash is currently on. That's showing me. You can see here. Yes. So there's a bunch, whole bunch of different things you can do with this app. And I also, maybe in my next video, I will be covering OBS also, how you can connect it to your OBS and use it there as well. Okay. So this is how it is. If I change it back to my front camera, I'll be following the preacher wherever it is, as long as my phone my phone is connected to a network. So it doesn't matter if your phone and your PC are connected to different, to the same network, they can be connected to different networks. Okay, right? So just get the IP address of it and put it on your phone where you are setting up the SRT. Okay, the SRT, you can put it on your phone and to enable it to connect to the system, all right, to vMix rather. Okay, so that's just it on this video. You can zoom out, zoom in, do whatever thing you want to do with it. You can see it's currently my laptop here. It just take maybe a little time before it will show that. Okay, so don't forget to hit that red subscribe button below and turn on the notification bell so you'll be notified whenever I drop videos like this. All right, so I'm just going to end this and I see you in my next video.